Hi, it's Kendra. I'm back with another watercolor painting of a skier hiking in the mountains, but this picture you see is not how the painting turns out. I actually take this finished painting and add a whole other layer to create an alternate ending. Am I going to wreck it? Stick around and let me know which version you prefer. I love painting skies wet and wet. The paint flows so easily, and if you keep lots of paint on your brush, everything blends for you right on the paper. By leaving white areas, you get soft, wispy clouds that wouldn't be possible if the paper was dry. With watercolor, you work from light to dark. I'm going to be painting a skier and some rocks down here, but since they are so much darker than my sky, I don't need to reserve the white paper for them or paint around them. I can just paint my wet and wet sky right over the area where they will be. Then once my paper is completely dry, I can add in the darker details that I want. When you put grains of salt on a wet painting, the salt pulls the paint towards it and absorbs the water, which can create beautiful snowflakes. Sometimes when a painting is quite wet, the salt isn't able to absorb all of the paint it pulls towards it, so a dark line can form around the salt. In order to prevent that, I'm just using some tweezers to remove the salt before it fully dries to keep the snowflakes clean. Here I'm just lifting out the middle of the snowflakes with a damp brush and pressing lightly with a paper towel. By damp brush, I mean that I've cleaned it and I've tried to remove as much water as possible, and then those bristles will wick the paint up off the paper, which is still slightly wet. If you use a completely dry brush, it actually doesn't lift the paint as well as a damp brush will. To achieve the detail I need in the rocks and skier, I'm now painting wet on dry. On dry paper, the paint stays where you put it, so you can get crisp lines, perfect for details. On the other hand, the snowbanks underneath, I'm painting wet into wet, so the colors bleed together and give the snow a pillowy softness. Do you see how in this other painting I did previously, the sky just works? The eye is drawn around the sky, but always comes back to the skiers. Whereas in this new painting, the eye gets lost up in the sky and struggles to come back down. So I just feel like this deserves another layer. It seems to be missing something to balance the picture. There's too much happening in the sky and it's drawing the attention away from the focal point. If I darken the sky, then I think it will help illuminate this area down here. But I have no idea if this is going to work. This is a total gamble. Taking a finished painting and adding a whole other layer, it's risky. It might work or it might not. How am I going to wreck it? I don't know, but I'm willing to take the risk because it's more fun to paint it than to always wonder. Re-wetting the completely dry painting allows me to work wet into wet, which is more forgiving and also gives me more time to play. The first thing I'm trying to do is cover up those distracting white snowflakes in the top right-hand corner. I regret using a paper towel on them, which made them so bright. They probably would have turned out fine with just the salt. As you can see, I missed a couple of spots. From the angle I was painting from, I couldn't see these dry patches. That could have been avoided by tilting the paper up towards the light, and then I could have made sure I had full coverage with the water. I think I've got it under control. I'm feathering my wet and wet wash around my skier using a damp brush. That way I won't need to be too detailed. If I was using a brush loaded with water or paint, I would have to be super careful to avoid some harsh lines forming around the skier. It could end up looking almost like an outline if I didn't match it up perfectly. So by feathering, I avoid that. If you need to feather something out, you need to dry your brush up incredibly well so that you don't push water into a damp area. So an area that's already started to dry and it needs to be feathered, you need a very dry brush. so tempting to get carried away by this. I just have to stop while I'm ahead. So you'll have to let me know in the comments if you like the new ending to the painting or if I should have left it the way it was. Did I wreck it? Well, I'm not crazy about my new sky. I do feel like my eye is more drawn to the skier and stays down in this area for a lot longer. When I look at the first version, the sky is very soft and pretty, but these snowflakes up here on the top right hand side distract and draw my eye up and keep it bouncing around and not coming back down. So while I don't feel like I turned it into a masterpiece, I think I accomplished what I set off to do. And I would still love to know your opinion of which one you prefer, and don't be afraid to tell me if you think I wrecked it, because either way, it was a lot of fun to paint. I hope you enjoyed seeing it come together, and thanks so much for watching.